boy, where do we begin with this one? So, Assassin's Creed, the film, has just come out in the UK on January 1st, 2017. It's been out in the UK, in the US for a while, and looking up to the film's release, we were hoping that this would be the film to break the video game movie curse, because they're not the best of films, let's be honest. And I had high hopes for this movie, because being a big Assassin's Creed fan, I wanted it to succeed, but unfortunately, it doesn't quite hit the mark a lot of people were expecting. Now, I'd just like to discuss a little bit about it. First of all, in no way is it a terrible, dog-awful movie. It has its moments where you'd be proud to be an Assassin's Creed fan. For instance, the parkour in the film when it's in Spain is fantastic. Even when it's in the modern day, it's believable. And that's my favourite thing about it. And the fact that Michael Fassbender actually did some of the stunts as Aguilar and, of course, as Cal, it's probably one of my favourite things about the movie. So that's a plus for me. One of the other things about the film that I really liked was the fact that the Animus was sort of like a projector. It was kind of like, instead of it being the traditional, you know, lying down and being put into this machine, even though that does exist in the film universe, they decided to go something a little bit different, and the way it's executed is quite clever. As a downside to that, the only issue would be is the transitioning from past to present is a little bit jarring, in the sense that you'd be watching Aguilar do something and then it'd instantly shift to Cal. And it'd be kind of like, whoa, what the hell's happening here? You know, you kind of lose track of it every now and again. In terms of the fighting is solid. It's just like what you're seeing on the screen here. They've managed to capture the fighting style of how assassins work and Templars, and they've congealed it into this sort of amazing, well choreographed thing. It's almost like a dance, like when you watch Pirates of the Caribbean and you see Will and Jack fight, or Jack and Davy Jones. It's just well choreographed. It's unbelievably good. And I really like Aguilar. Aguilar is a good assassin. You know, he's not in the game universe yet. He could come into it, but he's solid. Even though Michael Fassbender, when he plays him, doesn't talk as much. He only speaks in Spanish when he's as Aguilar. Obviously, he speaks a lot when he's as Cal. You know, he's the strong silent type, and that's one of the main things I like about Aguilar. And the opening scene with him is something that sets the movie on its course, and it's quite clever how they've done it without giving too much away. And on the sort of downside about it, it's kind of the pacing of the film can be a bit, little bit slow at times, and the villain, Dr. Ricken, I consider him very underused. He's a very good villain. He's a character in the games, and he just seems very underused. And Jeremy Irons is a very good actor, but each actor in their own way is good in this movie. There's no way the actors are at fault with this film. They had to work with what they've got. But Michael Fassbender makes a great assassin. He really does. The music to this film was very much like the first Assassin's Creed game. It gives you that historic vibe, and that's what I really liked about it. And I kind of wish Jesper Keed, I think his name is, had come back to do the film's music, because I would have loved to have that vintage touch to it. But obviously it was a Jed Kurzel, which I think is the director's brother. And so I really liked the music to the film, and when seeing the film, it made me want to come home and watch listen to the music and play the Assassin's Creed games, specifically the Ezio collection, which is what you're seeing on screen right now. But Michael Fassbender in this film is phenomenal. Marion Cotillard, I think her name is, that's how you pronounce it, is fantastic. And Jeremy Irons in his own way is fantastic as well. But seeing the leap of faith, which you're about to see here, live action, was one of the best things ever. It was well executed. The visual effects in this film were stunning. I do feel like there could have been a lot that this film could have improved on, but hopefully for the sequels, we'll get a better installation of the Assassin's Creed franchise. So, in summary, the parkour, action, music, and cast was fantastic. The pacing, use of the Animus, the transitioning, and the use of the villain was off. Give it a medium sink. Not the perfect game movie, but it gets the job done. So that's basically that, guys. And all that needs to clarify for you is this is a film you really need to go and watch of your own accord. I was going into it with not, I had high expectations, but at the same time I had low expectations. And the thing about this movie is, I see it as a not as a game movie, but I see it as just a film that's been crafted and they thought, let's see how this does, because I don't think Ubisoft are expecting a high payout for this movie, but I feel like it's a good fan service as any video game movie. But the past couple, i.e. Hitman, you know, we don't talk about that one, it's kind of been a bit of a letdown, and I did wish Assassin's Creed would be the one to bring it back, but in a way it did, but in a way it didn't, and I hope, like I mentioned, with the sequel, the improve on it a lot more and just clean things up a little bit. But me personally, I can't wait for a sequel, because I would love to see what direction they take the films in. Maybe they'll bring in people like Altair or Edward Kenway or Ezio, you know, just assassins like that. Not Connor, because Connor's not an assassin. At least I don't think he's an assassin. That's my personal opinion. And then the same goes for this movie. I liked this movie. Yes, it had its flaws, but every movie has its flaws. I wouldn't say this was one of the worst movies I've ever seen, because I have seen worse. But it's a solid film. I enjoyed it. I'm a big fan of the Assassin's Creed universe, but that's just my personal opinion. You may have an entirely different opinion to what I have on this movie, but I thought it was really enjoyable. And I am looking forward to more Assassin's Creed movies, and I hope Michael Fassbender stays on to them, because I find him exceptionally a good actor in this film, given what restrictions he has and what they had to work with. But it was a good film, and I would go watch it again. And who knows, maybe if I watched it, my opinion could change on it. Maybe that second time round I could say, no, do you know what, that wasn't as good as I thought it was, but who knows. So this was my Assassin's Creed review, guys. And I hope you understand where I come from with what I say about this film, because this purely is just my opinion, and everyone else is not going to agree with me. Some people might think it was really good, some people obviously think it's really bad, and given the rap it's gotten, you know, with Rotten Tomatoes and things like that, it's just very underrated, and I think it's going to be one of them films that obviously people will look back on and think, yeah, that film was rubbish, but I'd be the one who turns around and says, no, it was actually really good, I liked it. But I'm a fan, and I'm sure most people who would say it's rubbish have never even played any of the games or understand most of it. But then again, you would also have fans who would say it's bad, but who knows, only time will tell. So thank you for watching, guys, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.